yeah, everything starts is breeding, breeding the right material. Yeah. The input for how to breed or what to make, mm-hmm. what varieties to make,
yeah.
comes from different angles. So that is from the market, in Europe is from the retail market.
Yeah.
What does a supermarket need?
Yeah.
Or what does a food service companies need?
Mm-hmm.
But on the other hand, well, which is also very, very important, what do the growers need? In terms of agronomical criteria.
Is there a difference between, do you see then a gap between what the supermarkets want and what the growers want?
These are different worlds.
Yeah.
You have the world of retail, they are thinking in terms of consumers
mm-hmm.
and into a rotation of product on the shelves of the supermarket.
Yeah.
Or food service companies think in terms of taste
mm-hmm.
When they are running restaurants. Mm. And growers, they think in terms of production, easy to work with
yeah.
products,
yeah.
But
shelf life,
resistances. So that is more the chair of Leo,
yeah.
I'm the chair of Martin, and we discuss where we can find each other
okay.
together to serve the market. Because yeah. that it's about integration of.
But how do you integrate the market in finally in the activities which result in what Leo is doing? Do you invite them here? Or
yeah, we invite them here, and ideally, and that happens a lot, that we have the producer and the supermarket
yeah, yeah.
in one room.
Okay.
Yeah. And us. So we have this this triangle:
yeah.
supermarket, grower or grower organization. Breeding, and in the middle is the consumer. How can we serve the consumer, the shopper, in the best way?
Yeah.
But that's in Europe, eh?
That's Europe.
When you go to African countries or countries where this varieties we grow here in a demo, maybe 20% is possible there
yeah.
because of the resistance. It depends on the resistance of the varieties in countries. So the grower in India or in Tunisia or Morocco has to find out which variety growing the best in their country, because
yeah.
when you choose a variety here
yeah.
it will not grow in Morocco or Tunisia because of the climate and the resistance.
It's completely different.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
We
have
yeah,
different.
All the
so
lot
there,
of
yeah.
innovative facilities.
Yeah, yeah. So we are busy with a demo center in Almeria we have. And there is a breeding station who makes breeding with different resistance for the Mediterranean climate.
Okay.
And then it's easier for the grower to search in that block of varieties than what you're searching here.
Yeah.
This variety I grow, the 109 I have,
mm-hmm.
you can sell them, or you can grow them in from Russia, Europe, UK, Canada, Mexico, America, but not in African countries because of the climate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. So you have to choose different varieties with different resistance. So that's what breeders do all over the world for X1, to find out what's the best variety for each country,
yeah.
and then learn the growers how to grow it.
And how do you establish the contact with the market in these countries? Or do you focus mainly on breeding and resistance and climate conditions? Or do you also kind of market research in other countries?
In the Western world, 90% of the product is going to supermarkets.
Yeah.
But in Africa, Asia, 90% of the produce is going through, you know, open markets, street markets.
Yeah.
So there's a completely different approach.
Yeah.
And if you have in these countries, you have to really have to start with the grower to grow on a better way, to make better choices on varieties, better techniques how to grow, and. They are more in those countries. You really have to train the growers
yeah.
to give them example. While here, we are much more how to serve the retail markets, which
yeah.
is a completely
yeah.
different approach.
The retail decides what
yeah.
to grow on recipe.
Yeah.
Yeah. So in Europe, the whole tomato world is changing from the growing on recipe.